Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So today we're going to cover chapter 2, kinematics and linear motion. And as usual, first of all, I'm going to cover LO2.1. So LO2.1 is about linear motion. Alright. So we're going to cover this thing, LOC. Alright. Determine the distance traveled, displacement, velocity, and acceleration from the graph. So this is what we're going to cover inside the tutorial. Alright, so again, and somehow we also going to cover these parts. Alright, a little bit of this part. Okay, discuss the physical meaning of displacement against time, velocity against time, and acceleration against time graph. Alright, so step question number one. Okay. So over here we are given displacement against time graph. Okay, so in this question we are given the displacement against time graph. The motion of an object in straight line is shown in graph in figure 2.1. okay, so we're going to find first the velocity of the object for the motion given by AB, BC, and CD. Alright, so when we are given displacement against time graph, alright, you already learned that previously in AdMat, velocity is equals to dsdt. What does it mean by dsdt? Dsdt means gradient of the graph. Okay, gradient of the graph. Or s final minus s initial over t final minus t initial. Alright, so in order for you to calculate the velocity, you need to determine the final over initial. Means kalau dia A, B, maksudnya B ni adalah, B adalah final, okay, and A adalah initial. Just substitute into this formula, then you get the answer for B, A, B sama dengan, okay, then V, B, C sama dengan M, B, C, D. Alright, so shouldn't have any problem with this. Should not have any problem with this, okay. Just find the gradient of the graph. Next question B. The total distance, total distance, you are given displacement against time graph. So senang saja, tengok saja dia berat berapa. Daripada A pergi B berapa meter? 40 kan. B pergi C, dia terberat dah. Tak berat. Daripada C pergi D berapa? Okay, so tambahkan saja distance dia. Okay, baca daripada graph. So untuk B, soalan B, okay, kau tambahkan saja distance. Distance AB tambah distance A, distance AC tambah distance CD. Tak ada masalah patutnya. Okay, boleh teruskan. Next, the displacement. Okay, ada beza antara distance dengan displacement. Distance ni tadi kau tambahkan distance, okay. Kalau displacement dia ada direction. Okay, so kalau kau tengok dekat sini, daripada A pergi B dia bergerak 40 meter. Daripada C pergi D dia patah balik 40 meter. So kalau displacement, displacement dia kan sama dengan kosong. Kenapa kosong? Sebab dia balik ke tempat asal. 40 tambah negatif 40. So sama dengan kosong. Alright. Ha, itulah. D, the average speed of the object. So average speed. Samalah average speed. So D. Kan? Average speed kalau displacement. Kalau average speed maksudnya V sama dengan distance over time. Okay, kalau dia kata speed maksudnya distance over time. Tapi kalau dia kata velocity, displacement over time, itu untuk soalan lain lah. Tapi dalam kes ni ditanya, so substitute sahaja. Selesai question number 1.